Welcome back to Spell Tutorial Services. Today we're talking about the law of sines and we're looking at an ambiguous case. Because the triangle just gives us a side, a sine, and an angle, I've gone ahead and set up the proportion using the law of sines where I have angle A, 39 degrees, divided by its opposite side, 76 units, is equal to the sine of angle C divided by its opposite side, which is 52. All right, we cross multiply. And I'm going to skip a few steps here, but we see that sine C comes out to be 52 sine of 39 divided by 76. And when we take the arc sine of both sides, we see that C comes out to be approximately 25.5 degrees. All right. Being that we have the ambiguous case, we need to see if there's another possibility for angle C. So to do that, let's create a variable C sub 2, and let's do 180 minus the C value that we found, 25.5, and we see that C sub 2 actually comes out to 154.5 degrees. And to test this angle, we're going to add angle A plus this new angle C. So angle A plus angle C, and we know that that has to equal 180 degrees. So we see that angle A is 39 degrees plus this new angle C that we found, 154.5 degrees, and that gives us an angle of 193.5 degrees. Well, that's greater than 180, so we know we cannot use that angle is not possible in the triangle. So we're gonna use this one solution for C that we have here. So we know C is 25.5. Now, using that information, we're going to create. We're going to use the law of sines to figure out what side B is and what angle B is. So we know that angle A plus angle B plus angle C should equal 180 degrees. Well, angle A is 39, angle B we don't know, and angle C we just said was 25.5, all that should equal 180. And we know we add our two numbers together, we end up with 64.5 plus B is equal to 180. And through algebra, by subtracting 164.5 from both sides, we see that angle B is 115.5. So let's add that to our drawing here, 115.5, and let's also add C, which I said was 25.5. Alright, so that leaves us trying to find the measure or the length of side B. So to find that, again, use the law of sines. So we're going to take the sine of 115.5 divided by B. So I took the angle, the sine of angle B divided by the measure of its length is equal to the sine of 25.5 divided by 52. When I cross multiply, I get B times the sine of 25.5 is equal to the sine of 115.5 times 52. Isolate B by dividing. Sine of 25.5 on both sides . This here evaluates down to 1, so we're left that B is approximately 109 units. Alright, so that sums it up for this video on the law of sines, where we're working with the ambiguous case. We found that there's just one solution. Thank you again for watching a video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook and also subscribe to our YouTube channel, both found under the name Spell Tutorial. Thanks again for watching.